Ready to fight? Ready. Let's do it.
Well, great to have you with us tonight from Bell Center here in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. And per capita, these people make as much noise for mixed martial arts as any fan base in the world, and obviously a very exciting atmosphere for the fighters in Richmond.
It's a great environment for the fighters. It's a great experience for the fans. There aren't many places in the world that fighters love to compete in more than the Bell Center in Montreal. Nice punch to the head. Oh my goodness, what a kick!
Keep your hands up.
That punch, no good. Checks that leg. So more output, at least in the early going. Just misses with the straight right. Clean with the right hook. Missed with that right hand. All right, so he's dealing with some swelling upstairs, and you gotta think his opponent is gonna continue to attack that region.
Well, he has to. He's starting to see now the work that's being done. He's starting to see the benefits of the work with the swelling that's starting to occur.
Gets the single leg takedown. Nice positional control here. All right, so he just decides to get up here and let the opponent up.
Oh my goodness, that front leg kick, that front kick was nasty.
Oh! Oh!
Well, I'm no fighter, but if I rock a guy to that extent, I feel like I'm closing the show.
Absolutely, you gotta go close the show if you get a guy hurt that bad. Get out of that car and take your time. He's ripe for the picking. Go and pick the fruit.
Pretty good connection there, yeah.
Another one!
All right, so that opened up a cut around his eye area.
He hasn't moved his head well. He was taking shots too clean, and now a cut has opened up.
Both fighters hanging down in the pocket and both landing. Well, he's been good tonight, but he missed with that one. Just over 2 minutes to go in round one.
Beautiful job getting those hands up.
Well, dripping now from the lip. Unable to connect there. And a miss with the right hook. So at long last, he finally lands his first takedown after several failed attempts. You knew coming in that he was going to stay committed to the takedown, kept on trying, and finally got him to the ground. Ground and pound the hammer, Mark Coleman would be proud.
Another one. I mean, he cannot miss from the top position.
Hills in half guard. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotine. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in and you got all your rear choke submissions.
Oh, and there it is. Was only a matter of time. That ground strike has cut him open. Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has him. Watch our bar here.
Ooh, that looks wicked tight.
It's getting tight now. He's advancing.
Also, how about that position over submission as he bails on the sub?
I think that's a great job. You've got to make sure you don't end up in a worse position because you're trying to score a submission.
While the ground and pound has been on point tonight, good work here by Jamal Hill.
He's very accurate in the ground and pound, and is showing because he's landing so consistently.
That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, that's the end of the round. You see the fighter's got a cut on his lip, not necessarily a Robbie Lawler lip opening, if you know what I'm talking about, but certainly something that could be a source of adversity here moving forward. Cut man in there quickly to try to shore it up. All right, as they attend to the damaged fighter, we will re-rack some replays for you. A lot of damaging strikes landed by the opposition in that previous round.
Well, him just not really paying attention on the defensive side has made his opponent look like an absolute world beater. He's a good fighter, but he has never looked this good. And that is partly because his opponent is not defending.
Oh, the roundhouse kick lands. That's a big hook. And back to his feet.
Oh, the kick landed.
Well, at this point, DC, I'm not sure if he's just biding his time or just trying to get some extra reps, but go finish the guy.
It seems like the guy's playing with his food. You know, he's having a good time out there. Everything's working. He's in the zone. It feels like at any moment he can end the night of his downward bend.
He's got him hurt here. Crazy thus far. Both guys doling out a lot of damage, and neither seems too bothered by it, but clearly both parties are hurt.
Both guys are hurt. Both guys are fighting beautifully. Both are showing a lot of heart right now in this fight. They're both doing amazing jobs. Let's see who gets the job done at the end of this thing.
Just out of range with a big right hand. All right, so the cut really starting to open up wider now, and you gotta credit this striker for continuing to attack that area.
Just knowing the target, knowing what he's supposed to do, and doing it as effectively as he is right now. This guy's tremendous.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Oh, that's over.
By him there, and he continues to attack that cut. Pretty sage decision by him to target that area.
We always talk about his fight IQ, John. We talk about his ability to recognize his advantages. That's exactly what he's doing. The moment he saw that cut, I knew that would become his focus.
Well, he just hasn't been efficient with his strikes here tonight. There's another swing and a miss, and at this point, if he can't preserve some stamina moving forward, this is going to end up being an awfully long night. Lands another strike to the body, really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection, and these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Tried with the uppercut there, just missed, or so it appeared. Oh, he keeps attacking that left eye. Now it's starting to close.
He hit him again.
Connects there. Well, that left hand has been there at times, not on that attempt.
All right, relax, everybody.
Oh, my goodness.
Stay relaxed. Breathe.
Look at the torso on the right side. Major bruising, and it's only getting worse.
Nice block.
Oh! Diving punch lands. Oh, another huge ground strike land. Herb Dean steps in.
Oh, my God.
What a fight. So no judges needed tonight as he pounds him out for the TKO. I'm hoping I get an invite to the after party. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 46 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by TKO, Jamal Sweet Green Hill!
Well, the celebration is on over there in the corner, and nothing subdued about it. They put a lot of time into this.